With mobile devices, uploading and sharing is easier than ever. You can upload videos from wherever you are, as long as you have an internet connection. And we're seeing more and more videos uploaded every day.
With so many more casually shot videos being uploaded from different devices, the problem is many of these videos aren't of very high quality. For example, a video may be too dark, the audio could be noisy, the color balance could be off, or the video could be shaky, especially if it's recorded from a smartphone. Think about filming a video with your smartphone's camera. It's difficult enough to capture a moment as it happens, let alone holding your hands perfectly steady and moving the camera smoothly. There are several ways to stabilize a video. You can stabilize while filming by using mechanical features of the camera or sensors that track the camera's motion. Or you can stabilize the video after it's been filmed by analyzing the content of the images within the video. At YouTube, we wanted this to work on any video from any camera, so we use the technique of analyzing the video content. This method can take a lot of processing time. We can speed up the process by using parallel computation, which means to run several steps of the algorithm at the same time. You could stabilize the beginning of the video on one computer, the middle on another computer, and the end of the video on a third computer, and then reassemble all the pieces at the end.
The internet gives you access to the compute power of a data center at your home, so you're not limited to your own machine. So all you do is send a request to our data center that says, stabilize this video. And then we kick things off in the data center, computing the stabilized video, and simply sending it back to you. An algorithm is a self-contained, step-by-step set of operations in a well-defined language, for example, in a programming language. And it's used to compute a function. A function is simply something that takes multiple inputs and generates an output. So in our case, it takes this original video, stabilizes it, and computes the stabilized video. Our video stabilization algorithm consists of three main steps. First, we have to compute the original camera path. Second, we want to smooth this camera path. And third, we need to generate a new stable video. To compute the original camera path, we need to look at the video. A video is just a quick succession of images, which we call frames. A frame is just a set of pixels that are aligned in a grid, and each pixel just holds its individual color. Now, how can we use that to compute the original camera path? What we try to do is we try to find patterns across these frames to determine how things move from one frame to another. And what we do is we look at a small block of pixels and we try to find where it was in the image frame before it. That's a process that we call block matching. And then in the end, we take all these individual motions and we try to summarize it with some function, which is basically just linear algebra. And that is then the original camera pair. Our algorithm tries to mimic certain moves that professional cinematographers would employ. For example, if you put a camera on a tripod, you would have no motion at all. Or you would put it on a dolly, then you would have a motion with constant velocity. And so now our algorithm tries to find particular segments in the original video that it can approximate with these moves and blend between them. Now this new smooth camera path looks like a virtual camera in your original video. Think of it like as a rectangle moving around in your video. And we can stabilize it by simply applying a crop to that rectangle. So what we're doing here is we're effectively trading a little bit of image content for motion stability.
Building robust algorithms takes time, and they're rarely ever perfect the first time around. So we continuously work to improve our algorithms. And sometimes it's only through actual user feedback that we discover new issues, which we can then address. The internet has enabled us to create and communicate at scale. Without it, building complex solutions that require multiple computers would not be possible. Thinking computationally helps you to identify and approach problems and build solutions to have a tangible impact on the world.